created by Rio Grande.
San Joaquin Sheriff's Office calling all cars. Attention all San Joaquin County Sheriff's cars. Broadcast 184 regarding a murder in Stockton. Play the details later. That's all.
At this very moment, while I'm telling you the success story of police car performance with Rio Grande cracked gasoline, the police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and emergency equipment of your cities and counties are proving my statement. Every minute, Rio Grande cracked gasoline is powering some fire engine, thundering through city streets at top speed. Ambulances screeching their way to the side of injured citizens. Police cars doggedly cruising in your district, ready to leap into dashing, slicing speed, that you or your neighbor may have the protection and security to which you are entitled. Rio Grande is pardonably proud of this small contribution to your peace and safety, and of the acknowledgement by law enforcement departments of your city and county government that Rio Grande's cracked gasoline is the finest gasoline obtainable for police, fire, and emergency equipment. That's why Oakland, Berkeley, Fresno, Marysville, Bakersfield, Los Angeles, Pasadena, Arcadia, Monterey Park, Linwood, Colton, Glendora, Santa Barbara, San Diego, Phoenix, Glendale, Buckeye, Mesa, Las Vegas, Santa Barbara County, San Diego County, Coconina County, Maricopa County, Orange County, and many, many other cities and counties have specified Rio Grande cracked gasoline to power all their police, fire, and emergency equipment. We believe that you will agree that this is the strongest testimony, the most conclusive proof of gasoline superiority that has ever been presented to you. Why not follow the lead of those who know most about gasoline? Get Rio Grande cracked. This quicker starting, faster accelerating, longer mileage gasoline will give you a new conception of performance. Get police car performance with Rio Grande cracked gasoline at your independent Rio Grande dealers tomorrow. Pleasure and privilege this evening to present to you a man whose work resulted in the solution of tonight's case. Deputy Sheriff Rudy Weber of Stockton, speaking from San Francisco.
This program is a tribute to those men who swear on their word of honor to uphold the law and who, at the daily risk of their lives, do uphold the law. Whether these men are the common garden variety of the much-abused flatfoot or harness bull, the man who directs traffic on your city streets, the mild-mannered county sheriff, the detective who relentlessly pursues his quarry, the much-publicized G-man, or the little-known railroad special officer called a cinder dick, they are all working toward the same common end, the enforcement of the law, so that you and I and the other fellow can enjoy a reasonably amount of security and peace of mind. To these brave men, let us give all the credit due the protectors of our homes.
Night of September 7th, 1935, Rodney Gordon, a patrolman for the Western Pacific Railroad, bade his wife goodbye and drove to the railroad yard 1 mile south of Stockton, from which long trains of cars loaded with fruits and vegetables were moving like groaning leviathans toward the east.
How's the night going?
We're only busy or we couldn't handle it.
Lots of fruit loaded today, huh?
Aye, and lots of vegetables, too. Those Easterners must be awfully hungry.
I like to see stuff moving this way. It means things are getting better.
Well, say they are. Car loadings were up 50% last month.
How's Ed? Seen him around tonight?
Well, he's out checking up in the jungle beyond the south end of the yard.
I wish he'd clear that dump out. It's a menace.
Aye, if there's nothing we can do about it, though.
Apparently not. Well, I'll move you on over that way and have a look at things.
Say, you better be careful. Some pretty tough-looking lads doing this.
I know, but we got some fine loads spotted on those packs. We got to keep an eye on the stuff.
Hey, come back here. Say, What's the idea of always carrying your holster loose like that, huh?
Oh, I haven't needed that gun in years. I just carry it around when I'm in the yards, and when I come in, I always take it out and lay it around somewhere.
One day you're going to need that gun quick, and you'll not be able to get it out of the holster.
No, Dunk, you're too suspicious. The days of gunfighting are over.
Yeah, maybe so, but personally, well, I'd rather have a gun I could use.
I'll use my billy if I have to, but I don't want to shoot a man.
But those hobos doing the jungle didn't feel that way, huh?
Maybe not. Any way I can handle them.
I have it your way. Be seeing you.
I'll check in later. So long.
Uh-oh. Looks like a bum was trying to break open that truck.
Hey, you, get away from there.
Who says so?
What'd you say?
You hit me, copper. I said, who says so?
I say so, you bum. Go on, get going, get out of the yard.
Can put me out.
Now, come on, it's about time I stopped arguing and run you in.
That's with you, then.
Here, give me that knife, Al.
You know what, Doc? How you like that? Knife! Right up in me, will you, copper? I'll cut your heart out, and I'll drive this thing down as far as I can.
The next morning, S.W. Moy, the Western Pacific car inspector, is making his rounds checking air brakes when he stumbles over what he at first thinks is a sack of some yielding material. He shines his lantern on the object. Horror-stricken, he sees the mutilated body of patrolman Rodney Gordon.
Yardmaster Duncan speaking.
Hey, Dunk. This is Moy.
Yeah?
We've,
Hey, no, just a minute, man. Now, what are you trying to say?
Well, I just found Rod murdered.
What?
Yeah, just found Rod Gordon murdered.
Where?
A ribbon.
Oh, where?
Well, he's down here in the south yard.
All right, now listen. You go back there and stay there till I get there. I'll call the sheriff and Jim Foley. Go on, get off the line. I want to use this telephone.
James J. Foley, Division Special Agent for the Western Pacific Railway, had headquarters in Sacramento, 48 miles away. Dressing hastily, he starts driving to Stockton. Mile after mile, the roaring motor speeds him nearer the scene of the crime. Around curves, the breakneck pace carries him. Through small towns, past drowsy trucks groaning with their loads. At last, to a screeching stop at the yard office. 48 miles and 46 minutes. Foley is met by Yardmaster Duncan and Deputy Rudy Weber.
Right over there, Mr. Foley.
Okay.
Where are all those men?
The yard boys, sir. Moise there found the body.
Has anything been moved?
No, sir. Everything's exactly as it was.
Where'd this roll of bedding come from?
They found a balloon down the track away, sir.
Well, it probably belongs to Bird the Stab Rod. You ever see it before?
No, never saw that particular one, sir.
Well, let's take it along with us. Might as well let the ambulance boys take care of things here. Poor old Rod. Looks like he didn't have a chance.
Aye, looks that way.
Wonder where his gun is. I don't see it in his pocket.
Well, that's funny. All this carried it in his hip pocket. I was ragging him about it this evening when he checked in at the yard office.
Oh, here it is. I found it over here in the other track.
Must have fallen out of his pocket when he fell.
Looks like he never had a chance to pull it, sir.
Evidently didn't. Guess he dropped it when he fell.
He still had his billy in his pocket, though.
Probably didn't expect trouble when he stopped the bomb.
Hey, Mr. Weber, who's here? Here's a couple I found back here under the car.
Well, that's fine. That may prove valuable in tracking down the murderer if it happened to be his. I'll take it down to the sheriff's office and see what we can find out.
Find out about that balloon and cab, Rudy.
Our criminologist reported that according to the beard hairs found in a razor in the balloon, it belonged to a French Guinean or Cuban Negro. He figured the man would be between 30 and 40.
Hmm. That's an accurate description.
Well, it's as near as you can get with light, short beard hairs, Jim.
Yeah, I know it. I'm not complaining. I'm anxious to get some lead on this case. So far, nothing's given us the slightest clue. You find anything else in the balloon?
We found a pair of dark blue pants. Figured the man who wore them was about 5'5 or 5'6. We picked up a barracks bag down by the south fence this morning. Had a lot of junk in it, but nothing we could use as identification. I sent for old Jess this morning. He ought to be here pretty soon.
Who's he?
An old darkie who lives down by the tracks below the yard. The boys have been keeping him going for years with little things they give him.
Hmm. Do you think he'll know anything about this?
If he does, he'll tell us. That little tin shack of his houses as honest a man as you'll find in town.
I'll soon find out about that. What I want to do is get a definite lead to work on, then I'll take care of the rest.
Oh, that's probably just now. Come in.
You'll send for me, Mr. Webb?
Yes. Come on in. Close the door.
Yes.
Yes, this is Mr. Jim Foley. Oh, he's a special agent for the Western Pacific.
Pardon me, Mr. Foley.
We want to ask you some questions,
yes? Yes, sir. I've heard of you, Mr. Foley.
Mr. Weber tells me you're honest, Jeff.
Is that, Mr. Foley?
I want to know what you know about the killing of Officer Gordon.
Not a thing, sir. I don't know a thing. I wish I did, sir.
Jeff, have you seen anybody hanging around the yards who would be capable of such a brutal killing as this one?
Mr. Weber, I recollect I seen two men yesterday that might have done a thing like that. One of them was a black boy, and one of them was a Mexican boy. I don't think the Mexican boy would have done it, though. He looked scared to me. Looked like he was afeard of that black boy.
Jess, did you ever see this balloon before?
Oh, yes, sir. That's the same bed and roll that black boy was carrying. I remember them straps and the rubber handle on it, yes, sir. All the jungle boys know that balloon.
What kind of hat did he have on?
Oh, he didn't wear no hat, Mr. Webb. He had on a cap.
Is this the cap?
I believe it is, Mr. Webb. I believe that's the one.
You ever see these two men before?
Yeah, I see them once this week. Yeah, they were going past my place on toward the jungle. But I've talked to the colored boy off and on during the past 7 years.
Do you think they lived in the jungle, Jess?
Oh, yeah.
What did this black boy look like?
I'd say he was about 35 years. Must weighed around 150 pounds. He was a big husky boy, too. Had a big chest and big shoulders. He was a powerful man.
Have you any idea what he's called?
Appears to me like I heard the Mexican boy call him West Coast.
West Coast? That's a funny name.
Yes, sir. West Coast, so that's what it was.
Did this man have any whiskers?
Seems to me like he did. Yeah, sir, I believe he had a little fuzz on his upper lip. Yeah, it seemed like he had a little goat beard, too, sir.
Well, Jess, I think you've given us something to work on.
Thanks.
Foley, we'll round up the bumps in that jungle and see what we can find out.
Okay.
A dragnet was thrown around the vicinity of Stockton and every jungle combed. Scores of vagrants and itinerant floaters were picked up and questioned. The news of the murder of Patrolman Gordon had been broadcast, and excitement was a fever heat. Then, one day in early November, Deputy Sheriff Weber is questioned, a jungle habitué.
You ever seen this cap before?
Yes, I've seen it lots of times.
Where'd you see it last?
Well, boss, I can't say exactly. It's been most a month since I seen that cap.
Was anybody wearing it when you saw it last?
Yes, sir. I believe West Coast had that cap on when I seen it the last time.
You know West Coast?
Yes. No, sir. I don't know him. No, sir. At least I don't know him well. I seen him lots of times, though. Him and his that boy, that Mexican boy.
You know his name?
You all mean the Mexican boy? Well, yes, sir. We call him Chief.
No, I mean West Coast.
Oh, no, sir. I don't know his name. No, sir.
Can you describe him?
Well, boss, he had a sort of a funny-looking beard. And I remember that he was always sharpening that knife of his, too.
Did he always carry a knife?
Yes, sir. He had a knife that long. And he was always sharpening it, too.
Did you ever see this balloon before?
Indeed, I have. I've seen it lots of times. That belonged to West Coast. I seen him carrying it the day before Officer Golden was killed. Oh, he's a bad man, mister.
Yeah, I agree with you. You say he had a long knife. Anything peculiar about that knife?
Well, sir, it was a long knife made out of a file, I reckon. It's got a funny turned back point. Oh, he was always sharpening on that strop there on the balloon.
This West Coast, did he drink much?
He drank a lot of cheap wine, and he smoked Mary Warner, too.
Rudy. Yeah? A couple of youngsters here say they got some information for you.
Well, have them wait, will you, please? We'll see them in a minute. Now, look here, fellow. We aren't after you for anything. We aren't even going to put you in jail or do anything to you. But we want to know all you know about this West Coast mug. Now, have you ever heard his real name?
Well, let's see now. Well, sir, boss, I recollect I done heard his name once. Now, let's see now.
Oh, come on, man, think. What's his name?
Well, boss, I don't know whether it's his front name or his back name, but it seems to me like it's Floyd or Lloyd or something like that. I heard him say once that he's been arrested for knifing an Armenian down near the depot in Fresno. But that's all I know about him, so help me.
That's enough. We'll find him. Oh, Jim.
Yes?
Hop in your car and take a run down to Fresno and see what you can pick up on it.
I'm practically there now.
Oh, and send those kids in when you go out, will you?
Yes.
I'll see what they have to say. All right, boy, you can go now.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
You, Mr. Weber?
Yes, come in, boys. Mr. Foley says you have some information for us.
Well, yes, sir, we have it. It may not be much good, but we thought it might help.
We'll decide that. Now, Dory.
Well, sir, Bill and me, he's Bill, sir.
Hiya.
Yeah. Well, Bill and I was discharged from the CCC camp up in the mountains about the first part of September, see? We decided to go down and visit an aunt of mine who lives at Mojave's.
Mojave.
Oh, yeah. We was hitchhiking, but we didn't seem to be getting along so fast, so we decided to hop a freight and save our money. We was walking along down by the tracks on the south side of the yards, and we seen a light over in the jungle, I think you call it. So we went over. We thought maybe we could sleep there, but when we got there, we heard a man say...
There's a lousy sin stick around here that's been causing me trouble. He's going to get this knife between his ribs the next time I see them.
Uh-huh, my friend. You cut him with your knife, I cut him with my razor.
Sure, kid. You string along with me and we'll go places.
What places, for instance?
Well, me, I'm going east. I'm getting tired of this sunshine and heat. I'm going where they have real fall weather in September.
Me, I prefer the sunshine. Pedro.
Huh?
Throw more wood on the fire.
Throw on your spare.
That Pedro's a lazy dog.
Let's get him in a crap game. We'll use my dice, and if he don't like it, we'll cut his throat.
Better we save that for the cinder dick, no?
That's a fine idea, Chief. As a matter of fact, it's a swell idea. I think I'll go do it now.
Not now, my friend. We smoke a few more cigarettes, yes?
Yeah. Give me another marijuana. Boy, that makes you feel good. Say, Chief, I want to get started, so I'll take my balloon and get going. There's a freight leaving here about 4 o'clock, and I want to be on that freight.
So we got scared and beat it. We hid in a culvert till the jungle quieted down, and then we got a freight for Fresno. When we heard about the murder, we thought maybe we'd better come back and tell you what we find.
Well, I'm glad you did, boys. It doesn't give us much definite information, but at least we know the kind of man we have to deal with.
Gee.
Tell me, have you ever seen this bundle before?
Yes, sir. That's the bundle a man with the knife was sitting on.
Did you ever see this cap?
Yeah, that was on the Negro's head.
Would you recognize this man if you saw him again?
Yes, sir, I would. I'd know him anywhere.
All right, thanks. As soon as Foley gets back, I want you to help us identify any pictures he gets. We'll find that bird yet, and when we do...
Through the checking of records in Fresno by Deputy Rudy Weber and Foley, it was found that the true name of West Coast was Floyd A. Dale, a dangerous criminal with records in half a dozen states and many cities in California, as well as a prison record in the United States Army. Circulars were now broadcast throughout the country giving details of the murder of Officer Gordon. The weeks rolled into months as the search went relentlessly on. Then, one dreary day in January in Niles, Ohio, O.W. Guseman, a special officer for the Pennsylvania Railroad, is walking along the freight yard when he sees a man.
Hey, you! You up there by that tower?
Where have I seen that bum before? Hey, wait a minute, you. Haven't I seen you around this yard before?
Maybe you have, and maybe you ain't.
Oh, smart guy, huh? What's your name?
Smith.
You sure it's not Dale?
It's Smith.
Okay, come on. We'll go down to the Hoosgow and find out.
You're Joe Smith?
Yeah.
Is the man you arrested yesterday?
Yes, Your Honor. I picked him up in the Penn C yard.
And it doesn't look like the same man I booked last night.
No. I found this razor blade in his cell this morning. He shaved off his whiskers with it.
That right, Smith?
That's right.
What's the charge?
This man's wanted by California officers for murder.
Can you prove that?
Why, no, I can't prove it, but I'm sure he's the man.
Where'd you get your information?
From a circular sent out from Stockton, California.
Well, where is it?
Well, right here, in my pocket.
Doesn't look like the same man to me.
Well, that's because his hair is cut differently and his beard gone.
You print him?
Yes, sir. We've mailed the fingerprints to California officers.
Smith, is this your picture?
No, sir.
Where were you on September the 8th, 1935?
I was in Miami, Florida.
Well,
I can prove it.
Guzman, I'm not convinced this man is Floyd Dale. I see no reason for holding him for California officers. Smith, if I find you guilty of vagrancy, find the minimum fine of $5. Pay the clerk.
Boss, I ain't got no $5.
That case, we're going to have to keep you in jail until you serve out the fine.
That suits me.
Take him away, Joe.
I tell you, Judge, that guy is the same one who killed that officer in California.
If you're so sure of that, why don't you wire Stockton? Ask him if he found their man.
Well, that's just what I'm going to do.
Got an answer to my wire yet?
Oh, coming in now. Wait a minute. I'll read it to you. From your description and fingerprint classification, Joe Smith is really Floyd Dale. Hold prisoner at all costs. It's signed W.R. Groom, Chief Special Agent, Western Pacific.
That's all I wanted to know.
On the strength of the telegraphic information sent by Officer Guzman, Special Agent James Foley and Deputy Sheriff Rudy Weber and E.G. Hill left immediately for Warren, Ohio, where Dale was being held. On the way to California, a stopover is made at Chicago, and the questioning of Dale is resumed.
Do you deny that you're Floyd Dale?
I never heard of Floyd Dale.
Is this your picture?
What do you think?
I'm asking the questions. You answer them.
You heard me, didn't you?
Well, I think it's your picture.
Well, let's see your proof.
No 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 picture.
Well, let's see your proof.
Now look here, Westcoat.
Ah, my name's Smith. Who's Westcoat?
You know who Westcoat is. Take a look at this picture.
I'm looking.
You see that scar?
So what?
That's the same scar you have on your head.
It still don't prove nothing.
And here's a picture taken when you were in jail in Fresno. You notice any similarity now? No. Take a good look. Did you ever see that picture before?
No.
And here's a picture of a balloon found beside the body of Officer Gordon. Ever see it before? Here's a cap found at the same place. Is that your cap? Answer me, is that your cap?
Are you Mr. Weber?
Yeah, what do you want? Who are you?
I'm Roy Jones, homicide detail. Maybe I can help you with this boy here.
Well, you're big enough anyhow.
Don't need muscle with these boys. Gotta use your head. Let me talk to him by myself for a few minutes.
Okay, see what you can do. Come on, boys, let's go out and have a smoke.
Now, you listen to me, big boy. You in the spot. It ain't gonna do you no good to keep on saying you're Smith. That's the weakest alibi you can use. You gotta use your brain, boy. Now, I know what I'm talking about. Ain't gonna do you no good to sit down and sulk, neither. You're a smart boy. Now play up to it. You got a good education. You can figure things out. You can beat this rap, maybe, if you use your head. How's about it, boy?
Sure, I'm smart. I can outfigure these dumb cops anytime I get ready.
I know you can. Boy, you got what it takes to outthink these coppers every time. Now, me, I can't outsmart them. I'm too dumb. That's why I'm a copper. But you...
You're not... telling me. I know I'm smart. But when I figured that syndicate had been doing me dirt, I let him have it.
That's the way you gotta be. Beat him to it. Now, if I was in your spot, I'd say, yeah, I killed him. What are you gonna do about it? I'd tell him straight out. Give him a good story.
Yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll show these dumb cops where to get off. Send him in.
Come on, Mr. Weber. He's ready to talk now.
Okay. Well, how about it, Dale?
Sure, I'll tell you about it. Get your pencil and paper. I'll tell you. He was beating me over the head with a gun, and I killed him. I knocked him
in self-defense. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I ask you, was there ever a more pitiful defense or a more bald-faced lie? There lies the body of Rodney Gordon. 29 stab wounds in that body. His gun in its holster, and 10 feet from the slain man. His flashlight lying beside him. His billy, the only other weapon he ever carried, still in his pocket. Not one single evidence of even resistance on the part of this fine officer. And yet this man sits there and asks you to believe, asks this court to believe, that he brutally hacked and stabbed Rodney Gordon to death in self-defense. Moreover, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, bear in mind that Rodney Gordon was an officer of the law in execution of his lawful duty. This man had no right of resistance to such an officer. His act is one of cold-blooded, premeditated, bestial ferocity. His act was cold, calculated murder. You can in justice return no other verdict than guilty.
Almighty God, we beseech thee to have mercy on the soul of this man and to take him...
Never mind that. Come on, buckle on that strap.
Don't you believe in God, my son?
No, I don't believe in no God. A man can only die once. I ain't afraid.
Newspaper gives a personal interview to Calling All Cars News, about which he told us, quote, "It is one of the best ever written on me." You'll read two splendid detective stories, The Bamboo Snake and The Perfumed Cigarette Lighter, both doubly interesting because, like all Calling All Cars broadcasts, they're absolutely authentic. And, of course, the regular sparkling radio and motion picture news and pictures. In every issue, the current motion pictures are rated. Here's an unprejudiced guide to your motion picture attendance. It will save you time and money. Tomorrow, stop in at your independent Rio Grande dealers for your free copy of Calling All Cars News and for your Rio Grande cracked gasoline. Be sure you'll get Sinclair motor oil for this summer's driving. For unlike many oils you buy, they are de-waxed, de-jellied, and cannot break down in the most intense summer heat. That's just one of the reasons why, in spite of hundreds of brands of oil, that one out of every 9.5 gallons sold in the United States is Sinclair oil. So don't forget tomorrow, Rio Grande cracked gasoline, Sinclair motor oils, and you're Calling All Cars News at your neighborhood independent Rio Grande dealer.
Joaquin County Sheriff's Office calling all cars. Attention all cars. Cancellation broadcast 184 regarding a murder in Stockton. Suspect is now in custody. That's all.
Grande.